In Kilombero, things are not going too well for Amanda and Simone's rice crops. The rains began on time, but then tapered out, and they haven't returned. It's wet, but the fields are nowhere near flooded. Normally, the river would have risen at least 10 feet by now, but not this year. Some new tributaries have opened up, but Simone and the men still have to travel 3 hours just to find fish. With water so shallow and muddy, they'll only find catfish on this trip. School's out for the holidays, and the children have joined their parents in the valley. Rice growing is back-breaking work. The fields need constant weeding, or Amanda will find her rice seedlings smothered within days. The men will have to camp out tonight. It's too late to go home. Amanda is part of a neighborhood watch. The farmers take turns guarding the crop from stray cattle or hungry wild animals. Tonight, it's Amanda's turn. The early rice is already being fed on by birds. Amanda teaches the children to roll clay balls. Once hardened in the sun, they make useful weapons. This could be the only rice to mature this year, so everybody takes a turn at keeping the birds at bay. Rains are now a month late. Everyone's beginning to wonder if this ground will ever flood. They can only wait and keep busy. Every year, the family is prepared for the possibility of an incomplete harvest, but planning for the long-term future is more difficult. Amanda and Simone want a better life for their children. They hope that education will open the doors to new opportunities. Perhaps one day, when the children are grown, they'll lead a different kind of life and won't have to spend their days waiting out the perpetual cycle of the clouds and the winds and the rains. Charles's banana farm profits from a regular rainfall. The stability allows him and Provia to plan for the future.
Nzimbe nyumbe yonga nene rwansonga. Family egende gaziwa. Ewafe tulina olugero olugamba nti amaanyi ag'obuvubuka ge gakolera g'obukadde. Kati nsuubira nti ekiseera ejja kutuuka ng'ende kampuumula emirimu gyange.
Ezitandikire na n'ezikuza kumaliriza hati wano oreba aho nyingi nizi.
Nyingi n'ezi kuburayo. Amurimo ogukiriho n'ogwo gw'amaanyi. Okay, turi kuhika rwagati konke nyingi nyabwanje neza ukuburayo.
Mama kagukiriho.
Bizinesi zanyu zigenda gye. Ngiyeja ko.
Time for Charles to go back to Kampala. He's going to buy the boat he found there and get back to Lake Victoria before anyone else beats him to what he hopes will be a lucrative business, ferrying tourists to see the chimps. This is the biggest risk he's ever taken.
Tandika ebyobulambuzi bino mba neetaaga injini mpya nga nungi, mba neetaaga eryato eddungi nga tetufaanana na gano akafo ag'abavubi n'ebirala ebigenderamu.
Charles has just handed over the last of his savings, his profits from 10 years hard work in the fishing industry, in exchange for a chance in the tourist trade. In Kilombero, the rains are still proving elusive. And tonight, there's work to do.
Boku.
Hippos are voracious eaters. An adult can eat 40 kilograms of rice seedlings in a single night.
Kiboko sumpende kabisa. Ananisumbua kweli shambani mimea yangu namaliza. Kiboko ndio hatari. Kwangu mimi unanitaja hivi. Kama sika nikuja ndio unakaa hata kulala usingizi silali. Ananisumbua kweli boko. Kiboko mnyama hatari sana.
It's May, and the last chance of rain. Storms are practically unheard of in June. What rain they've had has been short-lived. This rain might be more than just a passing shower. This is what the weather should have been like a month ago. They'll need rain like this every day for several weeks if they hope to salvage their crops. Amanda knows downpours like this usually mean there's more rain to come. And although it happened late this year, this is what the Ngwatima family has been waiting for. More than 500 miles north on Lake Victoria, Charles is now the proud owner of his new tourist boat and a new business. Within hours of the downpour in the Kilimanjaro Valley, every pool and rivulet delivers food to the family table. They now have fresh fish right in their backyard. Two weeks of rain have completely reversed Amanda and Simone's fortunes. They still face the back-breaking, tedious work of tending, protecting, and harvesting the rice. But after months of worrying, at least they know they'll have a crop this year. Next year, Amanda and Simone will fight the same battle all over again, once more at the mercy of the very elements that make this land so rich. Here in Africa's fertile heartland, its Great Lakes region, hope and determination shape life and the future every bit as much as the water and earth.
Thank you.